What happens when your entire city gets stuck under a river? In Mobile, Alabama, the Wallace Tunnel, built for 35,000 cars a day, is now swallowing more than 100,000. It's not just a traffic jam, it's a bottleneck choking the Gulf Coast's main interstate. Now, after years of delays and backlash, Alabama's betting $3.5 billion on a fix. A new megabridge, rebuilt Bayway, and tollback deal that's finally cleared political gridlock. In Mobile, the Wallace Tunnel has long been the city's curse and commuters' daily gamble. Designed for 35,000 vehicles a day in the 1970s, it now takes more than 100,000, turning a vital east-west interstate into a daily choke point. For decades, the fix has been debated and delayed. A $6 toll proposal collapsed in 2019. But now, with a new contractor team, capped tolls, and major federal support, Alabama is finally moving forward. The plan isn't just a bridge, it's a full corridor upgrade. A 6-lane cable-stayed span over the Mobile River and a completely rebuilt bayway designed to survive the next century of Gulf storms. For a region that lives with hurricane warnings, this project isn't just about traffic, it's about safety, economy, and survival. First up, the Mobile River Bridge, a 6-lane cable-stayed span soaring over downtown Mobile, with 3 lanes in each direction and 215 feet of clearance for shipping, roughly the same as the Golden Gate Bridge. At full height, it'll be one of the tallest bridge decks in America. The main span stretches over 2,500 feet. No piers in the middle, no interference with the shipping channel. That's the power of a cable-stayed design. Big reach, minimal footprint, and a pretty nice-looking new skyline for Mobile. Then there's the Bayway. Right now, it's a pair of low-lying viaducts just a few feet above the bay, vulnerable to even moderate storm surges. A major hurricane could wipe it out. The rebuild? 2 new 3-lane spans raised 8 to 10 feet above the old deck, engineered to handle 100-year storm levels. This isn't just a bigger bridge, it's a defensive wall for Alabama's main east-west corridor. And here's the kicker. Most of this construction happens off existing roads over water. That means fewer closures, fewer headaches, and far less disruption than a typical megaproject. Interchanges are being redesigned for safety and flow, including one possible diverging diamond. Smart systems will monitor traffic in real time. In tolling, all electronic. No booths, no stopping. We'll cover that in a moment. So why build all of this now? Because I-10 through Mobile is no longer fit for purpose. What was once a modest tunnel under the river has become a national bottleneck. On some days, over 100,000 vehicles crawl through the Wallace Tunnel, choking not just commutes, but commerce across the entire Gulf Coast. The new bridge and bayway aim to fix that, adding 6 new lanes of hurricane-hardened interstate, easing pressure on the tunnel, and reconnecting a region that's outgrown its infrastructure. The impact? Peak hour delays between downtown Mobile and the Eastern Shore could drop by 90%. 90%. That's time back for workers, faster movement of goods, and more flexibility for growing industries on both sides of the bay. And Mobile's economy is primed to take off if its roads can keep up. The port's expanding, Airbus is scaling production, and a new downtown airport is on the way. But none of that works if trucks are still stuck in holiday traffic. This is also about climate resilience. The new bayway is designed to stay above water, which is kind of important, but even during a Katrina-level storm. That means safer evacuations, uninterrupted freight movement, and a corridor built to last through the next century of Gulf weather. Nationally, the stakes are bigger than just Alabama. I-10 is a transcontinental lifeline, and Mobile has been one of its weakest links. That's why this project won one of the largest federal bridge grants in recent memory, and why both parties in Washington have thrown support behind it. Bottom line, this isn't just a fix for local traffic. It's a bet on the Gulf Coast's future and a test of how America upgrades what really matters. As we like to say, no megaproject escapes scrutiny. And in Mobile, tolls nearly killed this one. In 2019, a proposed $6 toll on both the new bridge and the existing Wallace Tunnel sparked public fury. The idea of paying to use a tunnel that had been free for decades hit a nerve. Local officials pulled their support and the project was shelved. This time, the pitch changed. ALDOT, or Alabama Department of Transportation, returned with a compromise. The tunnel would stay toll-free, the bridge capped at $2.50 per trip, and unlimited use passes offered at $40 a month. Once the project is paid off, the tolls go away. That promise, plus written safeguards to prevent price hikes, brought regional leaders back on board by 2022. But the skepticism hasn't disappeared. Some worry the tolls will quietly creep up, or that the free alternative will become so congested it's no longer viable. Others question whether lower-income residents will bear a disproportionate burden, especially those who live farther out but commute daily. Environmental concerns also played a role, particularly around the Mobile-Tensaw Delta and sensitive bay wetlands. Groups like Mobile Baykeeper worked closely with ALDOT to ensure proper sediment controls and flood mitigation. The project passed its federal environmental reviews in 2021, but watchdogs remain alert. Construction impacts were another concern, especially for businesses along the causeway and residents near interchanges. But because most of the project is being built on a new alignment over water, disruption should be lighter than other highway expansions. Keeping two lanes open in each direction during construction has helped ease local fears. Politically, support is now widespread. Republicans, Democrats, city mayors, county commissions, cats and dogs, they're largely aligned. But the lesson from 2019 still hangs over the project, and trust is fragile. One broken toll promise, one communication misstep, and years of goodwill could evaporate. That makes transparency, affordability, and accountability as important as the concrete and cables themselves. The I-10 Mobile River Bridge and Bayway might seem like a uniquely Southern challenge, but it reflects a national dilemma. How do you build megaprojects today without falling into the same traps? Charleston's Ravenel Bridge is often held up as the gold standard. It opened in 2005, 8 lanes, cable stayed, iconic. But it was delivered in a different era, one where federal earmarks helped fill funding gaps. Mobile doesn't have that luxury. Instead, it's had to blend modern financial tools, bridge grants, low-interest federal loans, targeted tolling, and local buy-in. It's not glamorous, but it's how infrastructure gets funded now. Then there's Tampa. Their Selman Expressway was one of the first to use all electronic tolling. No booths, no delays, and it worked because drivers saw the value. Mobile has taken that page and added its own chapter, keeping free alternatives, capping tolls, and offering unlimited use passes to earn public trust. It's a test of whether user pays infrastructure can still be politically sustainable. Baton Rouge offers the cautionary contrast. Louisiana chose to widen I-10 through its city core. No tolls, but major disruption. Businesses are bracing for years of construction chaos. Mobile strategy? Build parallel to the existing route, mostly over water, and keep traffic flowing. It's not perfect, but it's far less painful. In all three cases, the lesson is clear. It's not just what you build, but how you bring people with you. Mobile has borrowed smart ideas, dodged major pitfalls, and adapted to today's funding realities. If it delivers, this won't just be a bridge. It'll be a blueprint. And if it doesn't, it'll be a case study in how even well-planned projects can fall apart without trust and follow-through. Is the I-10 Mobile River Bridge and Bayway a long overdue fix or just an expensive patch on a crumbling system? Frankly, it's both, but it's also something more. This project reflects the very best and worst of how American infrastructure gets done. It took decades of false starts, collapsed toll plans, and community pushback to reach a compromise that finally stuck. And while the traffic, climate, and economic rationale is clear, the politics are what really turned the tide. This isn't just about building concrete, it's about rebuilding trust. By keeping the old tunnel toll-free, capping costs for commuters, and offering transparent funding, ALDOT has pulled off something really rare in megaproject politics: actual consensus. Of course, things can still go sideways, the price tag is huge, timelines are tight, and in Alabama, tolls are always a touchy subject. But the alternative? More traffic, more flood risk, more economic inertia? That's worse. If this bridge rises as planned, it won't just carry cars. It'll carry proof that even in an era of fractured politics and fiscal anxiety, it's still possible to build something big, smart, and public-minded. And that might be the most valuable thing it delivers. The I-10 Mobile River Bridge in Bayway isn't just about fixing traffic, it's a test case for American infrastructure in the 21st century. If completed, it will be one of the South's most significant transport upgrades in decades. Flood resilient, freight ready, and future focused. A new landmark for a city that's often overlooked, and a vital artery for a region on the rise. But beyond the engineering, this project shows just how hard it is to build in America today. Years of stalled proposals, political fights, and public mistrust nearly killed it. What revived it wasn't just funding, it was compromise, which is what America was founded on, and that's kind of cool. Now, with broad support and a clear plan, Mobile has a shot at something rare, a megaproject that actually gets built and earns public trust along the way. Those two things don't usually go hand in hand with these things. Its success or failure won't just affect Alabama. It could shape how other states tackle the next wave of transport, climate, and growth challenges. Because in the end, this isn't just about a bridge over water. It's about bridging the gap between what's needed and what's possible when a city decides it's time to move forward. Would you pay $250 to skip an hour-long traffic jam? Or should infrastructure like this be free, no matter the cost? The Mobile River Bridge might be a model for the future, or a warning about what it takes to build in America today. So what do you think? Bold fix or billion-dollar overreach? Drop your thoughts below, and if you want more deep dives into megaprojects shaping our world, don't miss our videos on the Orisand Metro or the Fehmarn Belt Tunnel. The next chapter in global infrastructure starts here.